That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Second and four. He finds his man complete. That's Scott. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. On first down, Peters. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Well, thanks for joining us here on a Thursday night in the NFL. Third quarter, second and 10 coming up. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Now a handoff up the middle. One. And he's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Working with a 2nd and 3. Operating from the gun, Peters. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Looking to throw, Peters. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Colts have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead will be cut down to 14. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it culminates in an Indianapolis touchdown. The Colts kicking team is out there now, and they will send this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Well, don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a 2-score game, the interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here if they do indeed try to throw the football.
Yeah, and I was a little surprised by the last throw. You know, that type of throw with this type of a game, I'm going to be very careful about it. Maybe the only throw you make is maybe a toss to your halfback or something like that. Otherwise, take care of the thing and finish this bad boy off.
To throw on 2nd down, Rich. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. 3rd down. To throw on 3rd down, Rich. Hard throw, incomplete. The Falcons send out their punter as he's on to kick it away. And it's fielded at the 34. 35 yards that time on the punt. And they will take over 1st and 10. And the Colts coming out now. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a 2-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. On 1st and 10, Peters. He finds his man complete. It's Scott. So he stopped for no gain. And that's going to bring up 2nd down. 4th quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the 2nd touchdown. You gab the 1st one for the 2nd one to even matter.
Now a throw here to his running back. 5 yards. Now it's 3rd and 5. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along, but if you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
On first down, Dent, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up. On second down, Dent, and this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. On third down, Rich. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That's leaking to the right, and he missed it by a foot or two. It's no good, and this will remain a 2-touchdown game. Indy set to go on offense once more. Well, they didn't fall behind any further thanks to that missed field goal, but still staring at this fourth quarter deficit. Now, this one now not over yet, Charles. You've got a sliver of hope on that other sideline.
You certainly do, because that would have made it a 3-score game, and that probably would have been curtains at that point. But now if they can get down the field quickly and somehow get the ball back one more time, we may have a different ball game.
Looking to throw on second down, Peters. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. And the Falcons are going to take possession of the football. But here in the fourth quarter, defensively, you know that you're just going to blanket the field with defensive backs and say, okay, take your best shot. And that time, it's intercepted.
And we've often seen teams go into the prevent early, way too early. And sometimes they get too soft in their coverages. But not in this case. They understood the situation and played it with the proper aggression.
Throwing to start the drive. Rich, he finds his man, complete. That's Myers. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. To throw on second down. Rich, and he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. With that grab, he now sits at 200 for his career, and maybe more importantly, a first down. Back to throw, Rich. A quick throw knocked away, it's incomplete.
That's not the first time they've gone his way on this drive, and they were obviously keyed into him because they were there to help break that pass up.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up 2nd and 10. Up the middle they go. Dent. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. Operating from the gun, Rich. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Call it a loss of four there on the sack. And speaking of the number four, it brings up fourth down now.
Even keeping the back in for extra protection on third down, they still couldn't prevent the sack. Now it's fourth and long thanks to a terrific individual effort on defense.
So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. This to make it a three-score game late. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And that will extend their lead even further. So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a three-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, two scores is tough enough. Three, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
And the Colts getting ready to go. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds. They've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 23 yards the pickup there. A three-score game here late. You can probably rule out the comeback, but certainly some kind of a moral victory to be had if they can get a few more points to close things out. And to that end, a nice pass play there to push things downfield.
Yeah, and we know in this league, a loss is a loss, and no one wants anything to count as a moral victory or, boy, something that feels a little bit cheap. But if they trim that lead down to just two scores, that's still a benefit to this squad.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Looking to throw, Peters. And as he throws, he lost the football. It's loose. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage. But I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Operating from the gun, Peters. And he will find his man on the end route, complete. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down. Back to throw, Peters. And now here is another interception. And the Falcons will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. So another interception for him on the year. He is making quite a splash in his rookie campaign.
And most linebackers feel they're lucky if they get one or two of these a year, because once you start getting to 3, 4, and 5, that's when you know you've got a special player and someone the quarterbacks have to account for.
Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
On second down now, Dent. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. On third down, Dent. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down.
As much as I praise teams for being true to who they are, in this situation, I wonder if maybe they outguessed themselves a little bit. Third down, seemed like an obvious passing situation. They chose to run it and didn't get anywhere close to a first down.
The Falcons send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Looking to throw, Peters. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And my goodness, another interception. And the Falcons will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line.
Well, you think about it, though, that interception, great for his stats, but bad for field position. It was fourth down.
Yeah, terrific observation. If there is going to be a silver lining, and this is what he'll plead when it comes time to watch it again, hey, it was just like a punt, right? So we end up taking possession of the ball. But you're exactly right about it. Should have slapped it down. Field position would be better for his offense. But how many times do you get a chance to make an interception that you turn it down? That's when your instinct kicks in and you take the football. In this case, a better decision would have been to knock the ball down.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. On second down, Dent.
And they'll hold him to 3 there as he takes this up to the 47.
Throw on third down. Rich. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he gets this to the 48, but no further. Well short of the line to gain.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
The Falcons send out their punter. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. They'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field.
Well, probably not much that they can do at this point, CD. Down 3 scores late in the fourth quarter. This is going to be a little too much to overcome, you would think.
Yeah, they'll go down swinging, but in the end, I think we saw the writing on the wall a while back because one team was clearly better than the other in this one. And while it didn't quite reach blowout status, I think we knew who was going to win this one well before we got to this stage.
They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Throwing on first down, Peters. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. Operating from the gun, Peters. Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. On first down, Peters. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Back to throw again. Over the middle, complete. That's Wood. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He finds his man, complete. It's Wood. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Now one final throw here is incomplete, and that is how this one will come to an end. What a performance. All those points put on the board. And Charles, it wasn't just by the offense. The defense put some points on the board as well. They were solid today.
Yeah, it was a complete effort to secure the win, and both sides of the ball made big plays. But how demoralizing is it when the opposing defense can take one all the way back against you? And that was the case here. That really sparked them to victory.
So for the Falcons, they continue to put themselves in position for a first-round bye as they move to 8-2. And they'll get a few extra days to savor this one before they take on the New Orleans Saints. Meanwhile, for the Colts, it's a loss that sets them back in their playoff push as they fall to 6-5. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves next week at home against Jacksonville. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.
Run it up, touchdown.